Hi, I'm Pharaoh King, and you are tuned in to The Movement.
Ride the rave, ghost. I'ma go ride the rave. I wanna look at the stars today, ghost. I'ma go ride the rave, ghost. I'ma go ride the rave, ghost. I'ma go ride the rave. Thinking my cup and that dime today.
Dot XYZ.
Yeah!
So, my friends, I have a conversation for you. We're gonna get it in. This conversation, we're gonna be talking about ghosts, extraterrestrials, interdimensional traveling, and the wonders of the mind of an astral projecting individual like moi. So, first of all, happy holidays to everyone. Hopefully that you didn't go bankrupt spending all that big money on a day that was created by Coca-Cola.
A world without Santa Claus. It's hard to imagine. No boots, red suit, and white beard. But what many don't realize is what we're talking about is a world without artist Haddon Sunbloom.
I think now when people envision Santa Claus, they envision the Coca-Cola Santa Claus. Many of them don't even know the origin, the fact that Haddon Sunbloom painted this perfect vision of Santa Claus and kept his vision of Santa Claus consistent for over 30 years.
It all began with this 1931 painting. It's Sunbloom's first Santa, the one he created for Coca-Cola's Thirst Knows No Season campaign.
Santa Claus. But we all translate this day as a day for the family and love. So, cheers to you and your family. Happy holidays. Now, back to business. Let's talk about some ghosts, first of all. Now, I'm not sure how many of you actually had a very strange encounter before. Maybe heard bumps in the night. Pause. Well, I'm a person that has experienced a ghost in my life.
No. Oh! No, there's no ghost in there. We can even check from here. There. See?
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
And probably on more than one occasion. It makes me think, like, about this whole interdimensional idea. Parallel universes or parallel dimensions or dimensions on top of each other, or you know, some people would call it string theory. When I break all this stuff down, doesn't it sound pretty alien to you? As in, if we are actually the aliens, the avatars, right? Now, I love talking about these subjects, you know why? Because who doesn't like ghosts? Even if you don't believe, if you place somebody in a dark space, right? That's kind of eerie. Your mind starts playing tricks on you. Of course you're going to freak out, usually. Unless you're just very at peace with yourself in the dark. Now, where I'm going with this is this. What are ghosts? What are the things that go bump in the night? Now, when people leave this plane, right? Sometimes you can say they like to come back because they're not ready to accept that they're dead. My question is, why is it that people that are dead that do choose to come back, let's say that somebody captures evidence of these people, why do they always seem lost or hopeless or crying or weeping? Is it because that they chose to stay here, that they have lost all idea of what time actually is, because time cannot exist in a dimension, I would believe, that is not of this, that not of this plane. It wouldn't make sense to me that time would exist, a watch, time, none of that stuff. So, where I'm going with this is, once again, are we the space traveling interdimensional beings, actually? These avatar suits, are we the true aliens, is the question. Or not? It's debatable. Now, I would like to think that we are, because it would make a lot of sense, right? Like, we've been here before. Or maybe not. Everything's debatable. It's like when you look up in the sky and you're staring and gazing into the stars, right? maybe those could be someone gazing down upon us, staring back. But some people just say that they're planets. Or burning stars that are burning out, right? Or whatever you want to call it. What's this say? Swamp gas, according to the government, you know? Nothing's real. Everything's animated, you know? Like, we're just living in this earthly prison that we created for ourselves to be real and not to be spirit. Maybe spirit is really the real, true identity of us humans. We're spirit, we're energy, we are everything. We are, as God would be, a part of every single thing that's here. But yet, we think that we're separated. I don't know. What is real? What is aliens? And what is ghosts? And do you believe? And if you are not thinking outside the box, my friend, then you will be stuck in the box.